free, baby.
Yo, what's going on? It's your man QP representing the Rouge Collection. And today, we have a very special guest that came sit down and chop with us. You know, if you don't know who I'm talking about, just look to my right. The man, Travis, a.k.a. The Voice. What's going on with you, big dog? How you doing today,
man? Much of nothing, man. Just taking it one day at a time. That's about it.
That's what's up, man. You know, before we get started, I want to take the time to say thank you for taking time and come and chop it up with us and let us know what's up with you and Dead Game and what we can look forward to in the near future. So I just want to thank you for that, man.
Man, thank y'all for being interested, bro.
Gotcha. Now, we will jump right into it. Now, you know, Dead Game Records is a record label that a lot of people in Baton Rouge are definitely familiar with. You know, just to give a little history lesson, could you tell our listeners and our viewers a little bit about, you know, when it first got started and, you know, how the name Dead Game came about?
Well, we started in 2000, mm-hmm. and we really got going and momentum and all that around 2006.
Okay.
And the name itself, man, you know, it just comes from a way of life, man. It's a meaning that means, you know, through adversity and everything, you know, right. Never quit.
Right. Oh yeah, you can definitely appreciate that. Now, you know, a lot of times in the music business, a lot of CEOs or sometimes artists who were once rappers and then, you know, they got this situation straight and they became executives. Do you fall in that category or did you come into this business as a CEO or were you ever an artist?
Nah, I was never an artist, man, but you know, I've been getting the question a lot lately, so yeah. You know, we never know what may happen.
Oh, all right, so they're trying to get you on the mic to give them a
right,
few 60s?
Right.
Well, I'm pretty sure they got a lot of people that definitely appreciate something like that. Now, since you said that y'all been established since 2000, and you know, we're currently in 2014, so congratulations on being active as a record label for 14 years now. If you don't mind, like, could you share some of the things that you're most proud of from the moment you started the label up until this point?
Well, some of the things that I'm most proud of, I'll say, we got an artist signed to a major, okay. Which is Kevin Gates, which is signed to Atlantic Records now.
All right.
Other than that, man, I just, you know what I'm saying, I just enjoy the process more than anything.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
So there's nothing in particular, you know, you're just happy for everything that's going on and the progression you guys accomplished.
Right. And when you came from nothing, man, every little bit is, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I can feel you on that.
Right.
All right, now, I know you talked about, you know, Kevin Gates is one of y'all. This is like, we want to take a little time to kind of let everybody know some of the other artists that y'all have on the roster that we can look forward to hearing music from if they don't already know about a few of them.
Well, currently we got Malachi and Lil' and the Champ.
Okay. All right. So that's the two artists that pretty much are the focus of Dead Game right now.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, I'm familiar with Lil' when I listen to some of his music. He's tight, man. You know, I like his style, and you know, I'm gonna follow him a lot more. And hopefully, man, we can get y'all back in here and sit down with him and chop it up one of these good
ones. Oh man, all three of us, man. Whatever, you know. Whatever. Okay.
Right. Everybody. You know.
Right.
Pretty
right.
Much do a Dead Game Roots Collection takeover out here, man.
Most definitely.
Ain't nothing wrong with that, man. Now, aside from the artists, you know, what else do you have coming up in the near future as far as projects? And I know I saw online that we'd have a lot of t-shirts circulating around the city. You know, you want to talk about that a little bit?
Oh man, we got we have a barbecue that we've been doing it.
Okay.
And we're about to start it back up again when mm-hmm. the weather permits.
Mm-hmm.
As far as apparel and things, you know, we're trying to sell a little bit of everything that you can put your name on.
Right.
It's just a lot of different things we got going on right now. Just almost too many to name.
Okay, so they definitely got to stay tuned with Dead Game to find out what's next. So,
right.
Yeah, that's
right.
Good. You don't want to put everything out there.
Right.
Keep them anticipated right. So when they come out, they can be like, oh man, I didn't know they was doing that.
So I
could truly understand that. Now, how do you consider the current state of Baton Rouge music? Like, what do you think it's in a good space, or do you think there's room for a lot of improvement at this time with Baton Rouge hip hop?
Well, there's always room for improvement, no matter how good or how bad the situation is.
Right.
I mean, you know, from what I've seen so far,
mm-hmm.
it seems as if the market is wide open, you know what I'm saying, for
right.
whatever direction that the music scene want to go in.
Yeah, that is true, you know, because, you know, they have a lot of people that's making noise, so I could definitely understand what you're saying as far as, like, being wide open, and I'm pretty sure as a label, y'all plan on taking advantage of that lane that's
right, open. Right. Most definitely.
Okay, now, I'm going to get a little personal right now. Like, I know everybody listen to music, and as a CEO, I know you hear a lot of music. outside of your artists, can you give me some of the favorite, some of your favorite artists that's circulating right now? If I get you in the car with my man, The Voice, who are we listening to other than Dead Game artists?
Right. I'm glad you said that.
Yeah, because I already know you was going to let them know who, you know?
Who I'm listening to and who my favorite artists are two different things.
Okay, man, we got time, man. Let them know. You know, we trying to get to know you.
Well, as far as who I'm listening to, man, I like listening to your Jeezy, your Yo Gotti, your Drake, your 2 Chainz, Future, Rich Homie Quan.
Okay, yeah.
But as far as my favorite artists, I'm also like the hustlers in the business.
Okay.
Like your Diddy's, your Jay-Z.
Okay.
Even your Master P's and your Babies, you know what I mean?
Right. Oh, so, yeah, I feel you on that. And speaking of Diddy, man, I heard ain't no party like a Diddy Gang party. That's true.
I mean, hey, man.
You know, because Diddy one of the people that built the reputation on throwing these outstanding parties and bringing everybody out. And from what I hear about some of the parties that Diddy Gang, like the releases and the different parties that y'all have, y'all generate a pretty big response, man. So is that something that's accurate?
I mean, pretty much.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Pretty much that's what it is, man. And like I say, man, you know, we thankful for all our supporters.
Right.
You know what I mean? And, you know, we just steady striving for success, and you know what I mean?
That's real. Now, I know you've been around this business and you've seen a lot. If you could inspire or give some game to a young artist or a young entrepreneur, what would you tell them as far as bettering themselves and putting themselves in a position to be more productive and successful?
Don't come into it looking for nothing, man. Build your brain. And, you know, you can't skip processes and you can't skip over the grind of the music industry. You know, a lot of people want to go from A to Z. You know what I'm saying? It's not about that. It's about steady progress.
Okay. Now, before we finish up the interview, one of the last things that we like to do here at the Rouge Collection, if you could look in that camera and tell the world one thing, what would it be?
You know the name.
Man, Travis, man, I want to thank you for taking time and chopping it up with us. I want y'all to stay tuned to Dead Game Records. Follow them on Instagram. You got any shout-outs, anything you want to give to anybody at this time?
Man, I just want to give thanks to everybody who's supporting us, man.
Okay. Short and sweet, ladies and gentlemen. Till the next time, I'm your man, QP, representing the Rouge Collection, chilling with, you know the name, a.k.a. The Voice. Big shout-out to everybody that tuned in. See y'all next time. You say you want to take a ride, get in. I grew up on that other side.